This video I'll be turning this piece of copper wire into an explosive. So let's get into it. So to start, first off camera I've distilled some fresh nitric acid. I won't go in depth on how to make it, but if you want to, you can check out my making nitric acid video on my channel. So first to the flask I add small amounts of water, and that's to dilute the nitric acid that I'm about to add. The acid that I currently have is 100% nitric acid, which means it doesn't have water in it. And as we all know, 100% nitric acid can't dissolve metals. So when everything was ready, I've dropped in the copper metal and stopper the flask. What's happening here is the nitric acid oxidizes the copper into copper nitrate, which is soluble in water. This reaction produces some nitrogen dioxide, which is a toxic gas, and it escapes through the tube to outside. This reaction took around 30 minutes, and in that time I went to play some Fortnite, and after the reaction has finished I've transferred it into a beaker. So now we'll be forming our explosive, which is the copper tetraamine nitrate. First, I started by pitting some 20% ammonia hydroxide solution. What's happening here is by adding the ammonia hydroxide, we are lowering the pH of the solution, and that turns the copper nitrate into copper hydroxide. However, copper hydroxide doesn't last very long, and as we keep adding the ammonia, the copper hydroxide will redissolve, and that will form our explosive. As I add the ammonia, the light blue precipitate redissolves and a dark color emerges. I keep adding the ammonia until everything has dissolved. So there's still some stuff undissolved, but I figured that it shouldn't impact the final product too much. However, if you want a pure final product, make sure that your solution is clear. So I've prepared a new beaker and I've added 100 ml of 99% ethanol. As soon as I've added the original solution into the ethanol, a purple precipitate crushed out. And that's our explosive. Next, the solution was gravity filtered, however, I recommend vacuum filtration. If you want to have a higher yield, you can put the ethanol tetraamine solution into a fridge overnight and more tetraamine should crystallize. After the tetraamine has been filtered, I've put it into a desiccator. And here's our final product. To test it, I've decided to put some tetraamine on aluminum foil. When you heat the tetraamine, it starts burning and then spews out some strange cancer gas, which means that it can be confined, and when it's confined, it will explode. To be honest though, copper tetraamine is a really shitty explosive. I probably should have said it at the beginning, didn't I? I recommend making this for people who want to get into explosives, but don't want to lose a limb along the way. Copper tetraamine nitrate is relatively easy and it's not that dangerous. Thanks for watching everyone, if you like this video be sure to subscribe.